The doubling period of a bacterial population is 15 minutes. After 75 minutes, the population is 72,000. We want to determine the initial population and determine the size of the population after 4 hours. To model this population, we can use either an exponential function in this form here or this form here. Well, in the previous video, I solved this exact same problem using an exponential function in the form of p of t equals a times b raised to the power of t. So for this video, I want to show how we can solve this problem using the exponential function in the form p of t equals p sub 0 times e raised to the power of kt, where p of t is the amount after time t, p sub 0 is the initial or starting amount, k is the continuous growth rate, and t is the time. So going back up to the given information, if the doubling period is 15 minutes and p sub 0 is the initial amount, this is telling us that p of 15 must equal 2 times p sub 0. We're also told that after 75 minutes, the population is 72,000, which means p of 75 must equal 72,000. But let's start with the information about the doubling time. If p of 15 must equal 2 times p sub 0, that means 2 times p sub 0 must equal p sub 0 times e raised to the power of kt, but we know t is 15, so the exponent is 15k. So now we need to solve this equation for k. Notice if we divide both sides by p sub 0, the p sub zeros simplify out, leaving us with the equation 2 equals e raised to the power of 15k. And now we can solve for k. If we take the natural log of both sides of the equation and then apply the power property here on the right, so we can move 15k to the front. So we have 15k times natural log e on the right side of the equation. So we would have natural log 2 equals 15k times natural log e, but natural log e is equal to 1, so now we just divide both sides by 15 to determine the approximate value of k. So now we'll go to the calculator, and we have natural log 2 divided by 15. Let's go ahead and include 6 decimal places. So k is going to be approximately 0.046210. Which means now we know that p of t must equal p sub 0 times e raised to the power of 0.046210 times t. And now we can use the fact that p of 75 equals 72,000 to determine the value of p sub 0, or the initial population. Again, if p of 75 equals 72,000, then we'd have the equation 72,000 equals p sub 0 times e raised to the power of 0.046210 times t, which is equal to 75. So we can solve for p sub 0 by dividing both sides by e raised to the power of 0.046210 times 75. Notice on the right side, this simplifies to 1. So we have p sub 0 is equal to this quotient here, which we'll determine on the calculator. We have 72,000 divided by e raised to the power of 0.046210 times 75. Rounding to the nearest bacteria, we have 2,250 bacteria as the initial population. But this also gives us the information to determine the population size after 4 hours, because now we can substitute 2,250 for p sub 0 to determine the population function. We would have p of t equals p sub 0, or 2,250, times e raised to the power of 0.046210 times t. But we do have to remember that t is in minutes, and 4 hours is equal to 4 times 60 minutes, or 240 minutes. So to determine the population after 4 hours, we need to find p of 240. So now we go back to the calculator. I do want to point out, though, that in the previous video, when we used the exponential function p of t equals 2,250 times 2 raised to the power of t divided by 15, it actually gave us a different population after 4 hours. It gave us a population of 147,456,000. Now, the reason for the difference is that in this exponential function, we did have to round the value of k to 6 decimal places, which does make a difference, especially since this is part of the exponent. So we should be aware that whenever we round, there will be an error. In the other video using this exponential function, we didn't have to round, therefore this was the exact population after 4 hours. I hope you found this helpful.